Welcome to the Text Project, everybody, where we're going through the New Testament of the Bible by tackling one chapter every single weekday of the year. And today we're going into the book of 1 Peter. Now, you have to understand a little bit of history to understand the context of 1 Peter. Back in 64 AD, the city of Rome had some giant, massive fires. The reason they had these fires, many people believe, is because the Emperor Nero had set the fires. He wanted to make some changes in the city, and he wanted to be able to rebuild, and so he burned stuff down in order to be able to rebuild. Unfortunately, this didn't go in his favor. It turned around on him, and he began to get this backlash from people all over the empire. So he started a few rumors, got some people talking, and turned the anger from him to the Christians and made them the scapegoat for the fires. And so the Christians then became scattered because there was massive persecution that the church faced there. And so the context here, Peter then writes, he says, I am writing to God's chosen people who are living as foreigners in the provinces of Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia. These are all in modern-day Turkey. He says, God the Father knew you and chose you long ago, and his Spirit has made you holy. As a result, you have obeyed him and been cleansed by the blood of Jesus Christ. May God give you more and more grace and peace. In other words, he's talking to these people who are beginning to ask the question, is it worth it to follow Jesus? I mean, look, we got thrown from our homes. We got scattered from everything we knew. We have to live in hiding. The Christians were literally having church underground in caves. And they're thinking, is this really worth it? And so Peter reminds them that Jesus chose them long, long before the foundations of the earth, that because of what he did for them, they have a hope that goes beyond this earth, that they have an eternal hope and they should have an eternal focus. And these worldly things that they're going through, this persecution here on earth, does not compare to the eternity that they are going to face. And so he reminds them of this hope of eternal life. He calls them to live the kind of life that Jesus would call them to live. And so that's the context. When you're reading 1 Peter, remember, this is being written to people who are in hiding, who have been kicked from their homes because of their faith in Jesus. So anyway, that's the context of 1 Peter.